Good morning, students. Today we are going to start English subject, and in that we are going to start skill writing. Skill writing is a work computed in the various parts like letter writing, story writing, essay, comprehension, and so on. So today we are going to start letter writing. What is letter writing? Why we are writing the letters? Letter writing is the way, or we can say the method, to pass the message from one person to the another person in the written way. So let's see what is the letter writing. Whenever we are talking about the letter writing, that is bifurcated into two parts, types of letter. The first one is formal letter, second one is informal letter. Let's come for the formal letter. The first one, formal letter always should be right for the business or professional purpose, and the language of formal letter should be always simple language. And we are writing the formal letter to the government authorities or organizations, etc. Now come for the informal letter. We are writing informal letter for personal communication, and the language of informal letter should be casual or emotional tone. We are writing the informal letter to our family members or friends. So this way letter are bifurcated within these two parts. Whenever we are talking about the letter writing, so format should be most important. So for these two we have the different format. Let's see the format for the formal letter. So the first one, sender's detail. The first one is sender's detail. Whenever we are talking about the sender's detail, in that we have to write the name and address of the person, those who are writing the letter. The second one is date. At the second place we have to write date. After sender's address we have leave one line, then write date, and date should be in the form of like here, today is 26 August, so we have to write 26 August 2020. The next one is, next step is third one, receiver's detail. In the receiver's detail also we have to write name and address of the people to whom we are writing the letter. The next one is subject of the letter. What the letter is about, the subject should be in a smallest form, 4 to 5 words. We have to write in a brief what is the letter about. The next one is salutation. The fifth one is salutation, means we can write dear or respected sir or madam. The next one, the sixth one, is body of the letter. That is nothing else, actual message. Whenever we are talking the body of the letter, that is bifurcated within three paragraphs. The first paragraph is introduction of the letter. Whatever we are writing, introduction of ourselves and purpose, why we are writing the letter. The second is main content. In that we have to write detailed information about our letter. And the last para is summary. We have to conclude our letter. And after that we have to come for the seventh step of the letter, that is complimentary close, like we have to write yours faithfully. And at the last we have to write name and sign of the person, those who are writing the letter, and the designation if applicable. So this way, including this all 8 part of the format, completes the formal letter. If we remember this 8 part, so we can easily write the formal letter in a better way and score good marks. So this letter is not limited for our study. In our practical life also we have to use these kinds of the letters in our day-to-day life in various ways. So we have to learn this formal letter. So for that it is necessary we have to learn all these 8 steps. Now let's see how you are going to write that letter on the page. You can see here we have a part of the board like a page. Always we have to start our letter at the left hand side on the page, next to the margin. Here we have the red margin line, and always we have to start next to the margin. As we learn, the first one is sender's detail. Sender's detail. After that, date. The third one, receiver's detail. Then after receiver's detail, we have to write subject. After subject, salutation. Then after that, we have to come for the body of the letter. And after that, we have to write complimentary clause. And at the last, we have to write name and sign. Yes, this way we can say by using this 8 step. The first one, we are writing sender's detail. Second one, date. Third one, receiver's address. Fourth one, subject. Fifth one, salutation. Sixth one, body of the letter. Seventh one, complimentary clause. And eighth one, name and sign. Once again, I would like to repeat, sender's detail means name and address of the person, those who are writing the letter. Second, date, always we have to write date like the 26th August 2020 with the month's name. After that, receiver's detail, that is nothing else, the name and address of the person to whom we are writing the letter. After this, subject. Subject is what the letter is about, and that should be always 4 to 5 words. Then salutation. Respected or dear sir or madam, we can write. After that, body of the letter. Body of the letter means actual message, and that should be bifurcated into the 3 parts. In the first paragraph, we are at introduction, purpose of the letter. In the second paragraph, detailed information about our letter. And at the last, we have to conclude our letter. After that, complimentary clause. Complimentary clause like thanking you, yours faithfully, or yours sincerely, we can write. And at the last, name and sign of the person, those who are writing the letter. And if applicable, we should write the designation of that person. So this way we have to write our formal letter. This is the format of formal letter. Let's see. Here we have a question on the basis of that. Write a letter to principal requesting for 3 days leave. So this is a question you should write always on the left page of the book. Yes, the question you should write always the left page of your notebook, and letter should be always on the right hand side of the page. Yes, so as we learn, we have to start next to the margin. The first step, you can see sender's detail. So A, B, C. We cannot write our name in the exam, so we have to use A, B, C. Savdhan, Seva, Society, Kandivali, West, Mumbai, 6-7. We are written name and address of the person, those who are writing the letter. Then here leave one line. The second one is date. Today is 26th August 2020. We are written the date. After that, to whom we are writing the letter means receiver's name and detail. To the principal of SVN English School, Kandivali, West, Mumbai, 6-7. This way we are written the sender's detail, name, detail and date, and receiver's detail. The next step is subject. Subject. Application for
3 days leave. We are written the subject. Then salutation we have to write. Respected sir, and put the comma. Now the next one is body of our letter, that is, as I said, bifurcated into the three parts. So first one, I A B C, student of class, you are in which class, you should be right, of your school. I beg to say that I am not able to come to school for next 3 days from 27th August to 29th August, as because I am going to Pune for my cousin's wedding. So this way we have to written the first para. After that, I second paragraph we have to start from here only. I promise I will complete all my missing study work as well as homework. So please grant my leave. Here we finish the body of our letter. Then complimentary clause, that is nothing as thanking you, yours faithfully. We are written the complimentary clause. Then name and sign. So we are written the name A B C, standard and roll number. You should be right over here. So this way we can write a formal letter to our principal for our leave. First one, we are written the address. You can see the first one, sender's detail. Here we are the sender, as because we are writing letter to our principal. The next step is date, we are written. The next one is sender's detail, we are written. The next one is subject, we are written. Then salutation, respected sir, body, we are written body of the letter. We introduced ourselves and we are written the purpose why we are writing, and in the detail why I am not able to come to the school, we are given the reason. And at the last we conclude the letter. Then complimentary clause, thanking you, yours faithfully, and name and sign. So we should be write our name, class, standard and roll number. So this way we have to write the formal letter to our principal for leave. So this way we learn the format of the formal letter. Here you have the today's homework for you. Write a letter to the class teacher requesting for 1 day leave. Means you should write the same way whatever we learned today and whatever we written the letter to the principal in our video, the same thing you should be write to your class teacher. Letter is most important and that should be very beneficial to us in our practical life, and that is very easy also. You should be just learn these 8 steps of the format of formal letter. In a whole life you are never going to forget these types of the letter to write our way. So this way we have to write the formal letter. Thank you.